ఆదిభ్యో బ్రహ్మ విద్యా సంప్రదాయ కర్తృభ్యో వంశ ఋషుభ్యో మహద్భ్యో నమో గురుభ్యః సర్వోపప్లవరహిత ప్రజ్ఞాన గణ ప్రత్యగర్థో బ్రహ్మాహమస్మి సోహమస్మి బ్రహ్మాహమస్మి. ఓం ప్రపన్న పారిజాతాయ తోత్ర వేత్రైకపాణయే జ్ఞానముద్రాయ కృష్ణాయ గీతామృతదుహే నమః. ఓం నమో వెంకటేశాయ. మై బెస్ట్ విషెస్ అండ్ పరిపూర్ణ ఆశీర్వాదం టు ఆల్ ద వ్యూవర్స్ ఆఫ్ శ్రీ వెంకటేశ్వర భక్తి ఛానల్. మే ద ఆల్ మైటీ శ్రీ లార్డ్ వెంకటేశ్వర, హూ ఇస్ సర్వజ్ఞ సర్వవిత్ సర్వశక్తిమాన్, బెస్టో ఆల్ కైండ్స్ ఆఫ్ ప్రాస్పరిటీ, హెల్త్, వెల్త్ అండ్ ఎటర్నల్ హ్యాపీనెస్ విత్ పరిపూర్ణ లక్ష్మీ కటాక్షంస్ టు యూ అండ్ ఎంటైర్ యువర్ ఫ్యామిలీ మెంబర్స్ అండ్ యువర్ ఫ్రెండ్స్. లెట్ అస్ బిగిన్ భగవద్గీత వర్డ్స్ నంబర్ 31 ఆఫ్ 9th చాప్టర్. శ్రీ భగవానువాచ క్షిప్రం భవతి ధర్మాత్మా శశ్వచ్ఛాంతిం నిగచ్చతి కౌంతేయ ప్రతిజానీహి నమే భక్త ప్రణశ్యతి. భగవాన్ కృష్ణ అప్ టు వర్డ్స్ నంబర్ 29 హీ గేవ్ ద క్లారిటీ బిట్వీన్ వాట్ ఈస్ సకామ భక్తి, వాట్ ఈస్ నిష్కామ భక్తి, and also the benefit of both he distinguished, and also he finally said, so from the standpoint of Ishvara, how he would take all the bhaktis. Now from verse number 30 onwards up to the end of this chapter, I mean up to verse number 34, he is going to talk about glory of the bhakti. And this bhakti is not a jnani bhakti, I tell you. This jnani bhakti requires certain preliminary qualifications. They should have a sadhana chaturtaya sampannaha. You know, they should become like a person who is endowed with the qualifications which are known as a viveka, vairagya, shama, damadi, shakka, sampattihi, mumukshutvam, and jignyasa. So all these four sadhana chaturtayam said, the wealth which is known as fourfold qualifications. So those requirements takes long time. Once a upasaka does a long period of time, then alone he gains. But otherwise, this bhakti, whether it is artha bhakti, artharthi bhakti, or there are some bhaktis, you know, when we become sick, at that time also bhakti comes. So when you become sick, the bhakti gives more energy. Now scientifically it is proved. When you surrender to Lord, your tissues, your all cells becomes more potentially activated. And there is one person, I have to tell you, so one person called Bruce Lipton. So he is an American. So he has written a book after 25 years of research. The book name is Biology of Belief. Usually I speak about this book in my meditation camps. Because before starting meditation, you should know about your system, physical system, or the system which you got as a psychological system. So this both system is because of what cells. So he brings the theory of the cells. So every cell has got its own life. These cells are modified according to our DNA. Okay. So this everybody knows. We usually give our wealth to our children. But according to DNA, if father has got some disease, it also goes to the son. That's what karma phala is. If you are born to particular parents, you are also, you know, affected by their diseases. If the grandfather would have suffered by the disease of diabetes, then the grandson will get affected. We call it hereditary diseases. But this Bruce Lipton, he doesn't accept it. So this theory is from medical science, you know. But you know, you have to just know about my standpoint towards medical system. Any medical system we have to welcome. There is all medical system, even you know, allopathy, homeopathy, and there is Siddha, Ayurveda. Everything is for human nourishment. So all of them, they have plus point and minus point. Sometimes we have yet to reach the conclusions. So allopathy has got its own conclusion, which is not enough. Allopathy says everything is because of DNA. Your DNA is written according to your parents' DNA. But Vedanta says you are born because of your karma phala. This person who had an incident in his life, because in 25 years before, I think more than now, maybe 30 years before, so a person goes to an hospital in New York, and he wanted to check because he was having pain in his throat. Finally, doctors diagnosed, because in those days only they have limited equipments, therefore they diagnosed he is affected cancer. When they let him know, he asked, you know, how many years that I have? The doctor said, not my dear, so not years, maybe a few months. You just, you know, prepare for the departure. If Parikshit would have been told, the Parikshit would have been started Bhagavata, listening to Bhagavata, but this person who was not born in India, and he was terrified, because when you hear about yourself, you are not going to be long. When a person was told by the doctors, he became terrified and shocked. He went back. After 2-3 days, the doctors got the message, he died. So one among those doctors, he had the doubt. So something went wrong, isn't it? He went to his family and he requested for that corpus, and he did all research with that. He cut the throat. There was no cancer. Then he became very shocked, and that shocking, you know, it remained for a long time. He was not able to continue with this medical that duty. He left the job and he started researching the things. After 25 years of research, he wrote a book. That book is known as Biology of Belief. In that book, he says, this belief alone does the matter. When you believe, you become that. If you want to become something, you have to believe. Belief changes the DNA, not the hereditary things changes DNA. So thoroughly he has given. You can find his videos in YouTube. Still he is alive, giving lots of interviews. In one interview he says that I went to India and I had a long travel journey. Then I found so many things from the scriptures. How wonder it is. Now he says, so your body is maintained by your DNA. The DNA is because of your belief. Any disease can be cured by the belief. That's what he says. So now, a person, when he is affected by the disease, when he has the Shraddha towards that Almighty, definitely that Almighty will be in the form of belief. And we know how to construct the belief. Our rituals and our Sanatana Dharma, it has got steps of belief system. And we use all mantras, tantras, yantras, and not only that, we also have got so many rituals and so many different materials, medicinal plants, all together we can utilize for a ritual. So when a person who is affected by chronic diseases, when he gets the surrendering, he can become a devotee, no condition at all. A thief can become a devotee. That's what we say. Apichet sudurācāraha. Bhajate māmanyanyabhāk. Sādhureva ca mantavyaha. Samyag vyavasito hisaha. So he is considered as a good person because he reshuffled his all priorities. So once, you know, this right and wrong, why people commit mistake, why they become wrongdoers because of lack of knowledge. And many people, you know, society is not teaching, need not to be taught. In order to understand right and wrong, you need to have common sense, that's all. My Gurudatta says that common sense, just, you know, whatever you want, get anything from outside. You know, what always we wish everybody should love me, everybody should be positive with me always, all people should accept me. Whenever I want to go to them, I should be welcomed, I should be accepted, I should be prized. These all expectations that you have from others. Then you have to fulfill all the expects. What you expect, you have to show to others. That's all the common sense. You don't like anybody harming you. Therefore, you should not harm anybody. That's what the foundation of the dharma, the real law begins there. Then, when you are not having this common sense, but there is one conscience, which is in the name of manasakshi, it will make a kind of feeling, we call it guilt. This guilt becomes a very big problem. And people who commit this, you know, the work which is against law, I don't use crime, need not to use, but crime is the big word. The people who commit mistakes, small, small mistake, then it is converted into big mistakes. So because of what? Lack of knowledge, lack of awareness. But they said the guilt. So one person who had come to my guru, when he was the thief, we didn't know. He came and met Swamiji and he did namaskara and they were having conversation for more than 3.5 hours. Then finally Swamiji called me and asked me to provide lunch. Then I took him for lunch and he was having lunch and all. Then Swamiji said, let him be with you tonight. So let him be staying with you. Then for me it's okay. So I think he might have been one more brahmachari who has come for the spiritual progress. Then we should welcome. So I kept, I gave accommodation in my room itself. He was very nice and he was talking to me. The next day morning, there were people from department asking Swamiji, where is your Swamiji? I was standing in front of our ashram and I said, why, what do you want? Then they said, no, Swamiji gave the message. Swamiji had called us, we want to meet Swamiji. Then I took them to Swamiji and Swamiji asked me to bring that boy. I brought them. Then smilingly Swamiji just gestured him. And policemen saw, they took him to the jeep and that boy, he did namaskar and he was smiling face. And Swamiji said, so whatever I have told yesterday, please keep it up, don't worry. So everything will be taken care. Then the boy was sent to court and gave the punishment for 4 years. Then I came to know he was a thief. My God. So one day I spent with him. I become terrified. That's what the guru, you know, what to be done, to be done. If it is legally to be done, it has to be done legally. But Swamiji, what he did, you know, he sent all the CDs, cassettes, books of Vedanta. So which is usually taught in our 3 years course. Then, so Swamiji also conveyed the message to him, blessings. He studied from the imprisonment, okay. Then he became a sadhu. It's what in a glory of bhakti. He became real bhakta. He was well known. Then he came after 4 years. Then he wanted to continue life as a spiritual person. So now he is having a spiritual life and serving to the humanity. He established one institution. So still he is continuing as a brahmachari, but become very good person. And once we were discussing, at that time I asked, you know, so how do you feel now? Then he said, so I feel very good, I am out of guilt, I am able to serve the humanity. Then he was, that's what, you know, he has become devotee. And he loves to be a bhakta. So always these things, you know, it's important to be noted. So there is a norms of our legal things. There is a norms from the spiritual things. Both are not different. Because the Indian constitution, we have Satyameva Jayate. It is established on Satya. Therefore, nobody can go wrong. Bhakti can be begun from any stage. That's what I said, Valmiki, etc., etc., people. Kshipram Bhavati Dharmatma. When he leaves, he can adopt the bhakti. He can become great bhakta. He can become Valmiki. That has to be the lesson we have to learn. The bhakti means that much great things to have one's own life. Bhakti has got miracle powers. The bhakti can make a person cross thousands of janma within one janma. Shashvat chantim nigachati. He reaches a complete piece of time. He doesn't worry about society conditions because God has told yoga kshemam aham bahami. That yoga kshema means what? Taking care of all worldly life, including health and wealth, everything. Pratijanihi name bhaktaha pranashyati. I don't give up my devotee. I always protect. This is big line you have to note in your life. You have to note in your life these three sentences. Ma shuchaha mama bhaktaha. Me bhaktaha na pranashyati and aham yoga kshemam bahami. These are all message for bhaktas and devotees. Be sure and be assured and be brave to become a bhakta. Don't hesitate. Bhakta means, many people I have seen, they put bindi and they put all tripundrika while doing sandhya vandana, then after that they, you know, rub everything, they clean and come to the society. Need not to be. If you are a bhakta, you have to be confident enough. That's our rights. So whoever is born in India, that's our rights. That's our sanatana dharmas, the norms to continue with that. That's what he says. He becomes dharmatma. Dharma is nothing but a small understanding of common sense. It's very simple, isn't it? Next verse. Mam hi parthavya parshritya ye pesya papa yonayaha striyo vaishyas tatha shudraha te piyanti param gatim. Mam vyapashritya, surrendering to me, having shelter in me, all people who are considered papa yonis, all these people will get me definitely supreme level, which is nothing but me. Then next words, kim punar brahmana punyaha bhakta raja rushayastatha anityama sukham lokam imam prapya bhajasvamam. So in the last words, he says, so papa yonayaha, striyaha, vaishyaha, shudraha. So we need not to take literal meaning, we should not. Because a man has got the freedom, women are not having that much freedom. For them, still there is a difficult. If they go to a place, a man can go to jungle and can have the tapas. But women are not physically fit. They are physically maybe fit, but the society always protects, because society, especially our Sanatana Dharma, considers these females are mothers. Mothers need to be protected always. That mothers should be given priority. So that, you know, they don't have that much freedom, means which male have. But nowadays, all females, they are doing, all our mothers, I should say. So all of our mothers and sisters are doing well. That's what the glory of bhakti is. So when they surrender to Lord, they will be elevated like anything. And Vaishyaha Sudraha means, in those days, Vaishyas means they spend long time to earn money, not having time for pujas, rituals. Therefore, it is because of what? Lack of little bit karma phala. Therefore, it is considered here. And Shudraha, because they always do seva. They are not able to study. Therefore, it is considered. But nowadays, every one of us, we have chance. There is no obstructions. Jump to be a bhakta of your own ishta devata. You can select whatever the deity you want to select. Just convert yourself into a bhakti or bhakta. You elevate yourself as a bhakta. Merely you live as a human being is not enough. You have to become bhakta. You have to establish bhakti. I always say the fear, anger, jealousy, and all kinds of these emotional things are, they are born with us. Bhakti should be planted. You plant the bhakti, you see the life changes in a greater way. Kim punat brahmanaha punyaha bhaktaha raja rishayastatha. Brahmana means the people who can value Vedas, who can accept the God is everything. So those brahmanas by nature, the buddhi, brahmana buddhi, those because of punyam alone, they can become great bhaktas comparatively. Who are not having the chance, these people are having more chance. This comparatively, Bhagavan Krishna says, every one of us in our society, they have equal rights to become bhaktas. That's what he wanted to continue. That we will continue from next session tomorrow. Harihi Om. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Harihi Om. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om. Om Namo Venkateshaya.